Hi, hello everyone. Kyle here from For the Heart of Games. Today I'm going to be continuing Alan Wake. I'm going to have to remember how to play real quick. Do you have any weapons? I don't think so. Can you guys get me inside here? Doesn't seem like it. Are they gone? Cool.
Do something about the chain for the door to open.
Maybe I should be running instead. Ah! Maybe not. It's not opening quick enough. I see a thermos. There's 100 of them, I think, and I doubt I'm gonna collect anywhere near that. The darkness controls the Taken.
And here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of our local rock legends, the Old Gods. I couldn't tell you why. I guess it's just, you know, one of those things. Anyway, here's Poets of the Fall and their latest single, War.
Good. Good shot. Okay, that's okay. I know what I'm more up against now. Take me a little remember how to play.
And here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of our local rock legends.
Come on. Definitely not good. So close. Pretty sure I could use those barrels a lot better, but should be alright. Any goodies for me? Doesn't look like it. There's a thermos.
The power plant glowed in the night. It was close. But I had to find a way across.
You. All right, so the darkness doesn't like electricity. Sure, I don't either. So what am I gonna do about that? Did that turn the power off up here? Doesn't look like it. Yeah. Heisenberg. It's a raincoat, not a hazmat suit. Georgie. I'm not gonna get shocked, right? That's not good. Let's drop a flare. Did they vanish? Nope, they didn't. Where's the other dude? All these electrical wires, they're giving me that heavy rain vibe. I don't know if anybody else has played that game. It's really good. Okay, that looks like the way out, but I thought I was going the opposite direction. I'm gonna go back a bit, see if there's anything over there for me. Try not to get shocked in the process. Okay, that's where I came from. Okay, I guess not. It doesn't look like it. Thank you. Can you get more flashbangs, please? Right, I'm gonna take a look over here, see if there's anything I'm missing. At least so far, I feel. To go another rotation. Am I on the right side of the bridge? Oh, that's where I came from. I was on the right side of the bridge. Somebody damaged it from this side. So twilight zone.
Dreaming of being butterflies, or butterflies that dream of being men. Such philosophical concerns are, by necessity, abstract. And yet, some of us can find concrete proof of the nature of our existence.
Precise, I put everything here but that.
Really? But what is it?
Oh, I guess the temptation is
Listen, I also want to
help but wonder if all the people playing it are just people in the company that developed the game. Friends and stuff like that.
We managed to lose the flock! You're almost at the power plant! Keep going! We'll give you support!
I just wish they would have put the TVs in environments that aren't, don't have a lot of noise in the background so you can just pay attention easier. It's kind of hard to see it, especially like at that one with all the bridge noise in the background. I prefer to stay in your light. Can I do that? To use my flash playing. Kinda glad I didn't. Going off the same stamina. A lot of games lately, you know, you upgrade your stamina, you do stuff like that. I guess progressing better if you play. That flashbang. I was hoping to take out a lot more with it. Come on! playing by myself, I probably would have let myself die just to save more ammo. Should be okay though, hopefully. Forget about the flare gun. Unless there's crows. I should be using it more though. That was a good use of a flashbang. Although I probably could have just did a flare. Either way, it's okay. I don't remember if the flares actually kill him. I think it does.
I recognize the logo on the power plant sign. I'd seen a version of it painted all over the area, signifying hidden caches of supplies.
Safe haven.
Weaver, Cynthia, I'm a friend.
Prove it!
You knew Zane, Thomas Zane. You're the Lady of the Light in the song. You can help me.
About time. Young man, I've been waiting a very long time for you. It's in the well-lit room.
Excuse me?
What you need to drive the darkness back. Lit room is at the dam. I built the room to keep it safe.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
We won't go outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. We've been breaking the rules, young man, and where has that gotten us? Secret route. Lit route. Old water pipe. Damaged at the transformer yard. It drained all the reserve power. Without it, the pipe will go dark. The power to the yard must be cut.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules. I can't be outside in the dark. The kill switch is outside. Please, take what you need. This is all for you, for the likes of us. We do Tom's work, don't we?
Hurry! The switch is on the wall facing the shore.
How do you appreciate it, ma'am? That room seems pretty lit already.
Thank you.
come at me.
Sent me to cut the power to the transformer yard. I was willing to do grunt work for her to get her to help me. I hoped Weaver was dependable. I'd stumbled into this crazy world a little over a week ago. She had been living this insanity for decades.
And everybody thought she was crazy. I thought she was crazy. Maybe still is crazy. Maybe I'm crazy.
I could see the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it. If I could figure out the gates, I could use them to get to the kill switch.
I know, but I'm trying to figure out where this crate is. Nah, it's probably just pointing towards where it just was. I did, but I think I did it.
Transformer yard went dark and dead. Weaver's water pipe passage should now be good to go.
make a run for it? No, it's locked, isn't it? It would be. Open, 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 open. This is a bad idea. This is a bad idea. Yeah, that was a very bad idea. But I had a flare. If I would have thrown a flare down, I'd probably be okay. Let's try that out. I tried to, but I had it on flashbang. Make a run for it. Drop a flare. Hurry up, 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 hurry up. Open, 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 open. Let's switch, let's go. Ow. Gonna get inside.
This way, young man. Follow me. Come, come. The pipe's empty now. We're ready to go. This way. We need to go.
I knew them both, Tom and Barbara. Had such a crush on him. Such a beautiful man. I was jealous. There was a part of me that was maybe a little glad when she had the accident.
Oh, my gosh.
Then Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring it back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. Which looked like her, but it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. Oh, he was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. Oh, Tom. He left only one thing behind in my head, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse it. I built the well-lit room and put it there. It's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story. And none of us will survive to see the end. This isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to her own darkness.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me. In television, beyond, from below. We have both been touched by the darkness, young man. He saved us both with light. The darkness stays with you. You sustain. This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there. It's Sarah now?
Whoa! No! For the sweet love of...
Barry! Barry! We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
At least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.
Yeah, that would have been too easy for me to go down the pipe. Yeah, I didn't know if they were just going to keep coming. There's a lot of crows up there. Close to the end.
Barry! Sheriff Breaker! Sarah!
I don't want to finish the game, but I want to see where this goes.
The crash site looked bad, but as far as I could tell, the wreck was empty.
I thought I read something about DLC. There might be more content. I'm not sure, though. Back. Alright.
I have a different ending in mind.
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
I knew you'd be all right.
How's that?
The Flaming Eye of Mordor?
Laugh it up, funny man. Didn't we have somewhere to go?
Weaver will meet us at the dam. Got it.
They can't get us over here.
Bad guy's on the
Shoot
move.
Shoot him.
Right there. Where the
Was that it? Are we safe?
That was... wow. I think we're okay.
For now.
Hey, Al, I got a bad feeling.
Let's keep our eyes open.
Yeah, it's probably not gonna go that easy.
Thank you.
Harper's crazy, but she's got something Zane left behind. Something to fix this.
Gee, could you be a little more vague?
Thomas Zane? Seriously? Might as well be Paul Bunyan or Bigfoot.
Yeah, well, he was real.
Let's be careful, okay?
Oh, jeez, I hate this.
Okay, Wake. There's a button over there that opens the door. I think something's broken. Hold the button down so we can get in.
What about me? Can't say I didn't figure that would happen.
You guys go ahead and find Weaver. She should be in the dam now. I'll have to make it alone through the top. Go.
Ridiculously outnumbered. The searchlight could even the odds.
Stop.
Yeah, I didn't think so. You bear it. No, are you serious?
I was ridiculously outnumbered. The searchlight.
Oh my god, I don't like when games do that. That's ridiculous. Last time. Alright, let's go. It's probably gonna make me do it again. Okay. Good. That is bullshit. This guy gets tired. I swear, if I'm getting chased by that shit, I don't think I'm gonna tire out that easily. I'm just gonna go at a jogger's pace so I can save my stamina. It's gonna happen again.
wrong. It was a foolish chance to take. Don't worry about the noise. We're safe here. I have looked after the well-lit room for many, many years now. There is no shadow in the well-lit room. The power is failsafe, and both of the pumps are numbered and changed regularly based on their make and model.
Right.
And 118 need changing soon, and I don't want to climb up the ladder to change them because it's very late and I'm tired. And if you take it, I won't have to do that anymore.
The page was autobiographical, a memory from my childhood. But I didn't write this. It was a page written by Thomas Zane. None of them were supposed to exist anymore.
Alan, 7 years old, would fight sleep to the bitter end. When he did sleep, he soon woke up, screaming, the nightmares fresh in his mind. One evening, his mother, sitting by his bed, offered him an old light switch. She called it the clicker, and flicking the switch would turn on a magical light that would drive the beast away.
Am I a story?
To imbue the talisman with all possible power, she added that it had been given to her by Alan's father. Alan never knew him, and anything of his took on mythical proportions in his mind. With the clicker firmly in his hand, Alan finally slept like a baby. Now, almost 30 years later, Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
My mind swirled. I'd given the clicker to Alice, yet it was here. Zane had written it into existence in a story I had written. I can get to her now. I can finish this. Previously on Alan Wake, I wrote a horror story that has come true. Thomas Zane did the same in the 70s.
You will go no further.
If I continue like the Dark Presence wants me to, the story I'm writing won't save Alice. It's a horror story. No one will survive.
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song!
He left something behind to help me. The clicker.
Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
I can get to her now. I can finish this. Explode and the light hurt my eyes. I needed my sunglasses and painkillers to dull the pain. In one of my finer moments of self-deception, I swore to quit drinking. Ugh. The sunglasses made the world look bearable. Now I could keep my eyes open without feeling like a vampire in the sun.
Drinking is often a trope with writers. Anybody see 1408?
Hours worked fast. The prospect of being awake started to seem bearable again. There was a message waiting for me on the machine.
Me earlier and really choked me out. Yeah, we went a little overboard.
I'd been a guest on the talk show the previous night, talking about my latest book. The show was supposed to be waiting for me on our TiVo.
Sales figures, the two people out there who haven't read the book yet. But this last book is all about the death of the main character, the hard-boiled New York detective, Alex Kazin. Now, there's been a lot of outrage about this. Why the hell did you kill Casey? What the hell were you thinking, man?
Good riddance. No, seriously, though. 7 years and six books is a long time. He was a gloomy guy to spend all your working hours with, and it was a good run. But it's time to explore new things. My next book will be a departure from the old for me.
You selfish bastard. Always thinking of yourself. You've certainly given us a lot of entertainment over the years. And now that you mention it, Casey was a gloomy guy. Never had much luck with his love life with the ladies. Was that autobiographical in any way?
Yeah, no kidding. Casey's lady friends tended to die on him. With Casey, it was all about his pain. No. Nothing autobiographical about that. I'm a happily married man. My wife is my muse.
Well, congratulations. That's great to hear. So, how's the publicity tour been treating you?
Good. Great. But I gotta say, I'm glad to be back home in New York.
Well, you've certainly been on the news a lot lately. Lots of parties and, you got into a fight with some paparazzi.
Oh, man. Well, that guy was really in my face. I lost my temper. I know that wasn't cool.
You are famous for that temper.
Well, I did also write several books.
Well, your latest novel is called The Sudden Stop, and it's in bookstores now. Go get it. That means the two of you out there have it, buddy. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for you tonight. I want to thank all our guests for the evening, Alan Wake, Sam Lake, once more, do the face for a cent. And our musical guests, Poets of the Fall. Thank you.
At least I've been funny. I told myself I could live with that. I didn't say anything stupid, if that's what you want to know. Are you going to start with me about drinking now?
You know,
I should have followed her advice, but suddenly I was angry.
What? Now you can't even talk to me?
Well, this morning I was angry because you said you'd be home at midnight and you showed up at 7 a.m. and passed out in mid-sentence. Now I'm over it. Are you angry?
This goddamn tour. It's gotten out of hand.
Oh, honey. It's almost over, right? We can get back to normal and you can start writing again.
I'm sorry, honey.
Alan, you're not thinking straight. Just take a shower and go back to bed, huh?
Yeah. You're right, honey. I'm sorry. Once this is over, let's go away together. A vacation. Just you and me. Some peace and quiet.
Somehow, the clicker was the key to the cabin. I had to return to Cauldron Lake to save Alice. I'm going back to the lake to finish this. I'm going to write an ending to the story in the manuscript on my own terms, to make it all right.
Why can't you just write it here?
The last page is still in the typewriter. I need to read it first. Everything needs to be just right. Zane tried to cut some corners, and it didn't end well.
Okay, ready when you are.
I'm sorry, Sarah, but I need to do this alone. Barry,
Take her gun. Miss Weaver, close the door when I leave.
Good luck, Al.
See you later. When I got out, it was warm and sunny. I'd flicked the switch of the clicker. Had it done this? I didn't stop to question it. I had to take advantage of the sunlight to get to the lake. On Zane's page, I had stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, about to use the clicker. That's where I was headed. Surrounded by the beauty of the Pacific Northwest landscape, it was hard not to let doubt creep in one last time. I could still chalk everything up to a dream, a delusion. I had enough imagination to make up something like this, having been in the cabin all this time, trapped in a story inside my head, gone mad from grief over Alice's death like Hartman had claimed. There would be no way of knowing. I told myself it didn't really matter. My course was set.
Okay, I'll be right back. back. Sorry about that. I need to check my audio real quick because I accidentally hit the mic on my headset. So I didn't know if it switched that microphone rather than the blue snowball that I'm using. I think we should be good though. And this fly is driving me crazy. Goodness. It's about to make me crash. Dude, what's up? I took a shower. I should take this one instead. So used to open world games, and it makes me just want to stop and look around. Where this is like linear slash open world at the same time. At least in the driving sequences. That's probably all that's right here. There's probably something back there as well. Maybe not too important, probably just like a manuscript or something.
The darkness had touched me. There was a link between us, always would be. I could feel its presence again, getting closer.
Hopefully it's more ammo up there. Yeah, it looks like a manuscript. Fucking fly, dude. I think you died, but I'm not gonna bother turning around again.
Based on the signature in the motel register, Agent Nightingale had stayed here, in room number 2.
Your inventory a lot in this game. Room number 2. Let's check out the other. Can I check out the other rooms? No, doesn't look like it.
This had obviously been the room where Agent Nightingale had stayed when he hadn't been busy harassing me.
Maybe something out there, but it's a lot of area to look over. It's gonna keep on going. Okay. Can I get past here? I'm gonna block myself in. Okay, I'm good. Drop for a little bit. Why, this is not the time. Version of prop hunt where the props hunt you. You're dead. Really? All the way back here?
Hey,
think I even got hit before that. The one hit about killed me. Oh my gosh. Oh my, drop a flare. Oh, it's a flashbang. No. So I guess that's the construction equipment. I literally thought that was something with horns. How about if I go this way? Nothing. I'm not even there yet. Can't take it out from here. I'm gonna try a flashbang then. Hopefully that'll work. Try a flashbang this time and hopefully that works. It's dead. Why is it still coming at me? Go through a fence, really? Why, dude? Like, really? What do you want from me? I have nothing for you. This is ridiculous. Get out of the truck. I probably can't get over though. There was something back there. Yeah, so. Okay, let's back this thing up. Doesn't seem like I'm in danger at the moment. Switch to a pump shotgun. Get to the light. Pick up that manuscript piece. Are you guys gonna respawn, or can I go ahead and check out this area, see if there's anything good for me? Oh, I see people. Come on, light's right here. Let's go. No, you afraid? Come on. Is it even worth for me to backtrack? Probably not. Starting not to think so. Yeah, I'm just gonna bail on that. Take the ammo, but I'll stick with a shotgun because I have a good amount of rounds. Hopefully it's not a mistake, but we'll see. That was my only flare, really. Don't like when you pick it up, it automatically goes to it. So I don't always realize. Hopefully there's some more flares in here for me.
had to get the container out of my way. There had to be a way to power up the container lift.
It's a good thing I bought it, because it would have taken forever for this thing to lift up.
When I told Barry my plan back in the well-lit room, I'd acted as if I knew what I was doing. I didn't. I was operating on the shifting logic of a dream. I had to fight my way to the lake through the horrors of the night. I had to flick an old battered light switch imbued with childhood magic. I had to write a happy ending to a horror story. I had to save my wife from the dark prison she was being held in.
Probably did that a little premature. I can only assume there's going to be a lot coming at me right now.
I will never give her to you.
Oh. You guys are the worst.
I could see Mirror Peak in the distance. That's where Cauldron Lake was.
Goes there, wraps around there. Oh, okay. too quiet. Getting kept behind me, I feel pretty safe in here. fine. Let's go. Waiting. What the heck? Thank you. Thank you.
I needed to get the generator running.
Generator, are we talking about? Probably up there. Can I climb up this? Doesn't look like it. Got up there. or miss. Get up there. Oh, is this the generator?
Turn back now.
Okay. choices.
Never left you.
Thing hit me midair. Yeah, I'm in trouble. I'm gonna go down a flare.
Maybe you were having a bad dream. It was just another nightmare.
No.
Everything's fine. You're home.
It wasn't a dream.
Everything's fine.
Turn the lights on. Turn the lights on!
Shh, baby. The power's out. There's no light. Come back to bed and I'll make you forget all about your fear.
Because you'll probably kill me.
It's your fear. Why aren't you afraid? You're not Alice. Turn the lights on now. Where's the clicker? What did you do with it?
Alan, honey, you're still 1 foot in the dream. You're not making any sense. Come back to bed.
Alan, you're scaring me now. Come back
to my clicker.
Are you taking your pills? You want me to call Dr. Hartman?
I read your manuscript. It's brilliant. Departure is your best work here. You're a genius. I'm so proud of you. Come back to bed.
Come back to bed, Tom.
I want the clicker.
You must find your way to the cabin. It stands in your way. It won't let you pass. It has no heart. It's filled with darkness. You must fill its heart with light. Don't mind him. He's Mr. Scott. Your friends will meet him when you're gone. Use the clicker.
Wasn't true. Nothing like that had ever happened.
You're not my Barbara.
I promised it was good. Please, one time you naughty boy. I will help you reach your masterpieces. I will love you forever.
No, you're not Barbara Dagger. I made a terrible mistake. I should have never written back. You came back wrong. Your heart is filled with darkness.
Put that knife away, Thomas.
Cut it out. Take you back to the desecration.
I suppose the words that I'm shining on is actually creating the stuff that doesn't work.
Get away from me, you hag! Where am I? Let me go!
Alice! Alice!
Oh,
Now you will never get her back. I am much older than you. Older than your first work of art. I will find a new face to wear. Someone else to dream me free.
I could feel Alice's presence close by. I understood what I had to do now. I knew how to write the ending to Departure. There's light and there's darkness. Cause and effect. There's guilt and there's atonement. But the scales always need to balance. Everything has a price. That's where Zane had gone wrong. There's a long journey through the night back into the light.
Best.
ground control to Major Tom.
Yeah, I missed out on a little bit. I don't know if he dove in there and saved her in the story-wise, or... I don't know. I'm going to have to replay this to, I think, further understand it, but... Ground control to Major Tom. An awesome game, nonetheless. This was a lot of fun. Commencing countdown, engines on. 3, 2... Game episodes. Special one, the signal. Did I play that one?
Previously on Alan Wake. Something I only know as the Dark Presence held my wife captive and used her to write a horror story that came true.
I'll bring her back.
Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Alan?
I saved Alice, then wrote a better ending for the story. But not without a price. I was trapped somewhere in the dark place, a strange zone somewhere beyond our world.
It's not a lake. It's an ocean.
Okay, so this should be the DLC.
After the completion of any difficult undertaking, there are mixed emotions. Accomplishment and relief. Sadness, depression. For a while, everything was about the work. Like an illness, it consumed you. Changed you. You locked yourself away from the world to do it, and now you need to recover. Learn to live without it. Find a way to crack open the door and let the light back in. I knew this place. It was familiar, but wrong somehow.
Welcome to the...
Everything had a surreal, dreamlike quality.
I can't believe it.
I had a disturbing feeling of deja vu.
Alright, cool. So that kind of explained what I was thinking right now. So it seemed like he was kind of trapped while he let her go. Because he rewrote the ending. We're having some technical difficulties on my side though, so I'm going to go ahead and end this broadcast before it ends it for me. And I will be back. Thank you for watching, and bye!